Hello, I am Mangesh Kadam. We are going to discuss meaning of ideology. The term ideology has become very important from 18th century onward. The important reason behind the use of ideology in the politics at global level as well as national level as well had become very much important during this century, because this century, that is 17th and 18th century, had marked as the Enlightenment period or the modernization period. Why this period is very much important? Because during this period, individual had been given much importance. When I say it's individual had been given much importance, means that the established traditional understanding of giving importance to church or religion and considering importance to the idol had been challenged, or the term idol was replaced by ideas. When I say ideas, ideas of individual, ideas created for the benefit of individual, and individual himself or herself can create its own ideas. So ideas can be studied, ideas can be created, and individual is the sole creator of ideas. Individual is sole creator of world. This understanding had come up from Enlightenment period. In that sense, this understanding was based on real life and real society. When I say real life and a real society, it is challenging the extra natural authority or divine authority, saying that individual has great importance. In that sense, what is the important? That the community is important and individual is important. So during this period, rather than community, individual and individual's right had been given much importance. At one level, individual had been given much importance. At the level of government, the established government of kingship or king or monarchy had also been challenged, because the authority of king was considered as justified by divinity, or king had been considered as a divine authority which had no any relevance. Divine authority had no any right, or divine authority had totally been rejected by the understanding of real life, by the real society and the individual liberty. So the individual liberty, individual right, gave rise to the rule of people and not rule of king, because rule of king has no any justification, but rule of people under the name of democracy has justification, because individual is a rational being and individual know what is good and what is bad. In this sense, this understanding led to different kind of ideas and different kind of ideologies as well. So the ideas which had given much importance to individual freedom, that again converted into ideology of liberalism, and the ideas which had given much importance to group, to community along with the individual, that became ideology of socialism as well. Meaning of ideology. Ideology always gives us particular lens to look toward world and understanding the world. In that sense, it becomes the system of belief. So how you are perceiving the world? The important thing is that when we are looking toward the world, that particular understanding comes with particular class, comes with particular group. When the world is understood from capitalist perspective, then you will find world somewhat different. And when we are trying to understand the world from working class perspective, at that time somewhat we will find world very differently. So ideology always comes with social class or social group. And it is always said that ideologies are always comes with the ruling class as well. The class which is dominant or the ruling, that always creates its own ideas or ideology as well. It is also action oriented, because it always comes with set of ideas which always try to either challenge the existing system or to legitimize the existing system. Then ideology always becomes action oriented. If you want to understand particular phenomena, then you can explain that particular phenomena from different point of view. So for example, industries or industrial activity can be explained from liberal ideologies as well as from socialist ideology. So ideologies can be understood, ideology as a set of ideas as well as ideology as science of ideas. Every ideology or every ideologue claims that it is a science of ideas. So when I say set of ideas, for example, liberalism always having set of ideas like liberty, freedom, terms or democracy, representative form of government would always come as a set of liberal ideas. or when I say Marxism or socialism, then proletariat revolution or the communism or the class or class struggle would become a set of ideas. However, when I say set of ideas, in that sense, set of ideas means ideas are particularly defined in that particular ideology. In that sense, there is no any way to criticize those ideas. In that sense, ideas becomes matter of faith, and ideas become matter of love or hate. Love toward our own ideas, hate toward other ideas or ideology as well. Because ideas, set of ideas of that particular ideology always considered to be very superior as compared to other ideology as well. So this ideology as a set of ideas always try to either talk about what should be the form of government, who should be the ruler, what kind of rule should be there. So in that sense, I can say liberalism would say there should be democratic form of government, representative form of government, or people should be the ruler and law should be the enacted or created by the people. However, if we can take example of socialism, would say that the government should be led by proletariat class, proletarian should become the ruler, like that. So ideology always try to define what should be the structure of the government. So this defined path doesn't allow criticism. In that sense, this set of ideas is somewhat closed nature. In that sense, this ideologies always legitimize the existing system, or it always try to revolt against the existing system. Ideology as a set of ideas always try to either sacrifice for particular ideas or hatred toward particular ideas. For example, nationalism would always compel the people to sacrifice for the nation. Communalism would create hatred among other communities. In that sense, ideology is always closely related to politics, because ideology as a set of ideas always try to intervene into creation of particular form of better society, into creation of particular society, or it try to prescribe particular model, it becomes political ideology. When I say ideology is a science of ideas, so ideology always try to form particular ideology, always try to understand the distortion in particular ideas. In that sense, ideology always considered as a science of ideas. This understanding has been given by Dister de Tracy and Francis Bacon as well. Dister de Tracy and Francis Bacon says that ideology is said study of ideas, and the study of ideas is very empirical in nature. It is based on knowledge on the basis of sense organ. It means it becomes science of idea. It becomes a systematic study. So the science of ideas, ideology as a science of ideas, says that any ideas can be studied. Distortion of ideas can also be studied. It can be segregated from false ideas. For example, Marx says that whatever ideals or ideas have been created in the society with respect to what is the state, what are the rules, what are the laws, are all created by capitalist class, and hence that is false. But Marx says that whatever understanding he is giving, whatever explanation he is giving with respect to criticizing capitalist system or explaining what is the nature of capitalism, he says that is scientific in nature. So every ideology would claim that ideals or ideas which had been created by that particular ideologue or ideology is science. In that sense, ideology is also can be considered as a science of ideas as well. Then particular theorists or particular thinkers, they are trying to understand ideas, that becomes science of that particular ideas. But when they give meaning, when that particular state is being created, this is the idea, this is the ideal situation, this is the ideal society, that becomes the set, particular set of that particular idea. We have discussed set of ideas. Set of ideas always becomes a matter of faith. It always considered as superior to other ideas, and there is no any way for the critical thinking altogether. Set of ideas is always passionate for the establishment of particular form of ideal society, form of particular ideal government. So in case of science of ideas, ideology as a science of ideas always try to critical examination, critical investigation. It is always somewhat study of distorted ideas, study of how idea had been formed, how ideas had been distorted, how idea had been created. In that sense, science of ideas always goes very close to theory rather than faith. So set of ideas goes close to faith because this cannot be challenged. That is the final word. But with respect to science of ideas, it becomes theory. Why I am saying it becomes theory, because theory always allow to criticism. Every ideology is at point, at some point is science, as well as that ideology always becomes set of ideas as well. Thank you so much.